Hello, my dear students. How are you all? Hope everything is great at home. And today, you know, I am here with you with a topic from the English, that is the comprehension. Comprehension. Comprehension means to comprehend. It's to understand. It's to understand. And here, this comprehension. What it happened, we use this comprehension to test and improve the learner's ability to understand the language. We use this comprehension to test and improve the learner's ability for what? To learn the language. So this usually, you know, for class 5, 8 and for other students also, this question is very important, especially in English, and it's very easy and good way to score marks also. If you know this, the systems, how to do, you know, some of the things, if you remember, then it will be very easy to score the good marks here. Sometimes 10-15 marks it comes in the exam. So you need to understand what it means. It is basically, it comes in reading section. So you will get a passage in this comprehension. So we call this also as an unseen passage, where you were not aware of this passage. Why we call this as unseen passage? Because you were not aware of this before. You did not get this passage before, like in your textbook and all, what your syllabus, you did not get this passage. But in reading section you get this, which were not covered, which were not given, which you did not get in your textbook. So that's why it is called an unseen passage. And for that you have to read thoroughly, which by paying attention. You read it carefully. First things you need to do is you read it very carefully. Then some questions are given here in will give in your question paper also, but I am giving here on the board to show you how we can write the answers of this passage. The questions are given below. Okay, so you read this first. So I will read out for you. Okay. Once a greedy man had a goose that laid a golden egg every day. He sold the golden egg in the market. This made him very rich. His greed increased day by day. After some time, he said to himself, "My goose lays one egg in a day. That gives me 7 days in a week. That gives me 7 eggs in a week. That is a very slow process," he said. I will kill it and get all the golden eggs at once." So he foolishly killed the goose. There was no gold in her. There was no gold in her body after killing. So all the goose are same. The greedy man wept and repented for his folly. He said, "Oh, I have lost my greed. I have lost my greed." So this is what the passage is. So after reading, you just try to see the questions. What the questions asked. First question: what did the goose lay daily? What did the goose lay daily? What it gives? No, what it gives daily? So you will find in the passage what gives, what the goose it gives. You will, some of the students, what they do. So you will write from here, a goose that laid a golden egg every day. You will write all this part as your what answer. Most of you do these things. A goose that laid a golden egg every day. You are not trying to make a correct answer in an appropriate way. So simply you are writing this. This may be somewhere it is correct, but whenever you are asked a question, you know that you need to write how the questions it is. So you begin in such a way. So according to the questions you need to answer. It is not that simply what it is written in your passage, just copy it down. You need to be creative. You need to write from your own. It is not like the same what like ditto. You need to. It is not necessary, no. If you do this, what it is written in the passage, and same thing if you have written, you will not get the marks. Maybe half marks you will get by writing this, but not the full marks. If you want the full marks, then you must write in such a way that it look like you are writing the answers according to the question. So what you can write here the answer, like you start from the question, the goose, then this is in present indefinite tense, right? This is in present indefinite tense. The first form of verb lay. The first form of verb lay. So whenever it asks here the present past indefinite tense, this did is in past indefinite tense. If the questions can ask by taking the helping verb past indefinite tense, so in the answer your answer should be in the past indefinite tense. So how you will write the goose? The goose then the goose you have written, then lay past indefinite tense, you will write laid. This is what laid. Laid, what it like? You can write from here a golden egg. A golden egg. A golden egg. Yeah, every day is there. It is correct if you write every day also. But what it is written in the question, it is good to write in the answer also that daily. Daily. So this is what your answer is. So again in the second question you will see, how did the man become rich? Again here what helping verb it is used here in the second question, same the past indefinite tense. So here also when you will write the answer, your answers should be in the past indefinite tense. What? In the past indefinite tense. How you will write? Now the man, so generally the students they used to write like where it is, how did the man become rich? Maybe you will write he from the passage, you know, the second, no? This is your answer first, how you used to write in the exam, but this is not a good way. This is the correct way to write. And the second one you will write this one, he sold the golden egg in the market. He sold the golden egg in the market. So that's why he become what? Rich. Maybe you will use this line for your answer. But if you do so, then what? Somewhere you will get the marks, but not the full marks. So here you can write. You can write, start with the question, from the question. The man become. This is also first form of verb. Then the helping verb it is here did. So you can use what? You can use make it become became. When the question, you know, when the question it is in a simple indefinite tense, the answers you also make it in simple indefinite tense. So did, it means simple indefinite. Here also did, simple indefinite. So the answer should be in simple indefinite. So became. Here become would, will become, became. The man became rich. How? By by selling, yes or not? By selling the golden egg in the market. How? By selling. So you have already written became. So again, sold. No need to write sold here. By selling the golden egg in the market. By selling the golden egg. The golden egg in the market. This is the correct answer. Then the last, why did he kill the goose? Same, why did he kill the goose? What you will write, you know, you will write, I will kill it and get all the golden eggs at once. You will write this sentence as your answer. Most of the students, they write this as your answer of question number 3. Most of you write in this without changing anything, without writing or changing this pronoun also. Simply, most of the students, you used to write the same word here. So that's why you are not getting the full marks. So what you can write, why did he kill the goose? So you will write what it is in the question. You write, he, then I said, did, if it is did, then you make it past indefinite. He killed the goose. Why? Why he killed? To get all the golden eggs at once. To get all the golden eggs at once. This is your answer. You have to write he, not I. Most of you, what you write in the answers for question number 3, I will kill it and get all the golden eggs at once. This, most of the students, they write in this way and it become wrong. So sometimes the teachers, they feel pity on you and they give half marks. But if you write in this way, then you will get the full marks. Then the last word, it will be very easy. And here, there is no any trick, there is no any rule that I have to tell you to find out the words of opposite words of these words. You must know, you must read these words, opposite words of these words, then only you can write it. You can find it from here. So find the opposite words of wisely. Which one is the opposite words of wisely here? And which one is the opposite words of decrease? You just try to find out wisely. What is the opposite word of wisely? What you can write? Foolishly you can write. Yes. Foolishly. Decrease, what you can write? Foolishly it is there. Again, decrease, find out, you will get in the passage itself. See, decrease, increase, you will write this increase here done, again, increase also, okay. So this is what, in the last questions, you need to read, you need to remember the opposite words, then only you can write out. But the other things, these techniques, these tips, or in this way, if you will write, then only you will get a good marks. So today I hope you have learned something, how to write the answers after reading the passage. And if anyone having any doubt, then you can dial me, you can just tell me where you are having the problems, so that I will help you to understand that. So today this much only. Thank you very much.